I was gonna take a while, but I was having a very good sort of guessing when we do game drive yesterday that in 2 days' time, yesterday before, in 2 days' time we have to I mean go down to the west. They might come back into the area, and yes, they did. Unfortunately, they met with Mopoho and they all go back again.
So when you found them this morning, Rex, just quickly to update me as well, because I've just caught bits of it today, but you found the two Mapochos and a female this morning, eh?
Yeah.
And the Styx female. Guruma female, Styx female.
Yeah. And yeah, we're tracking them, but we're lucky because we get here at Vietnam driveway, we find that they were coming from the west. And we go there and we find the tracks, they cut to the block. While we are going there, we had millions. I see something like a line. I said, no, it's just a line. Let me go there. When we go down there, he said to us, it looked like they are coming into the bushes, but it are lions. We saw a female, but look like are 3 miles there, the way they look. I said, no, it's fine. Let's go there. Then we get there, we find them the way into the open. 2 miles and one female. The other one, Shaka. You call it Shaka. And the other one, Master Chi. And one of the female from Styx Pride. Then we get to the area. And I realized something wrong with this alliance. From the view, I thought, oh, they are mating. But I can see that the male is there, female is there, and the female, she's just lying down flat. She's not moving.
It's
Although
just
it
like
could
little
be,
mating, not in a big way, yeah.
it could be flies that buttering her. It doesn't want to move. You just stand still and look at the mouth. Was really amazing. And we were sitting there. We went out and come back, tracked, and finally tracked, went back. And they all went to the west and find that we had that they're located down to the west. I said,
oh,
no.
So all the Styx were here, huh?
Yeah, they're
on the
all
track.
here.
So the whole pride was here,
So
the Mapochos came, the rest of the pride left. And
what happened, I'm not sure, because if you find there in the Garimane, the information, the males were fighting and they were all running to the north. And we heard that there were three of males that crossed down from Baboon's Pen. You find that there's 2 males. But they were fighting against one. And the others, the time there were those two fighting with the other minority boy, the other three, they were coming from the west and crossed, coming from the south and crossed to the north because they can hear the fight and so on. So the other two, it looked like they chased that minority man all the way down to Bushbuck Dam. And he crossed to minority and they decided to leave, to leave him. And
it's just quickly to put it into
down.
perspective, because some of these names might not mean much to you, but Bushbuck Dam is right in the northern boundary of Buffalsoek, so our northern neighbours on their far side. In a straight line, Rexon Bushbuck Dam probably 4 or 5 kilometres,
yeah,
6 maybe,
6 somewhere
it's
down
a,
there.
It's a big distance.
So the, we had them the line down there, but they were chasing minority boys, and we have seen before because we have seen a lot of tracks, a lot of information. Also, yes, the line they were fighting, but we hope maybe. The minority boy was joining Styx Pride, I believe. Leaving Styx Pride. And the admirals, when they come, they got him there. And they chase him all the way down to that side. Which is really, really amazing. And we, yeah, looking forward, maybe the Mapoko must stay here into the area. Because there's quite a lot of different scent of the females that look like they are on into the area.
Yeah.
That will encourage those pride to start to be like checking all the females down here. Maybe the females will start to move more to the west, not to come back, you never know. Because when we are about to leave for morning drive, Styx Pride, the Styx females, she got up and
I heard, she just kept it.
and I was laughing, I said, look, that tells us, I mean, Styx Pride doesn't like those Mapoko males, they're all like running away from them.
But from the tracks, it didn't look like there was any fighting between them and the females, huh?
No,
them and the male.
There's no information. I have tried to go into the bush because most of the time when the line going up into the bush is where the mat lose the youngster. You see, we have checked all down that there's no cub that has been killed.
Yeah.
That tell us Mapoho, they can sense the Styx Pride that is part of thy gene.
Yeah.
It might not belong to those two males. It might be belongs to other males.
Yeah, but they don't, or they don't know who it belongs to.
Yeah,
so it's one of the good things when I saw them last year that was that, that the cubs were around those males and they were fine around the Mapoko.
They're fine. So they won't kill them. They might be like trying to bring or trying to push that female or some of the female that are on estrus that might be interested to mate. So the cubs themselves are safe. I believe, very, very safe from Mapocho, which is very good news. We were like, because today when I got the tracks, I was like stuck on my mind. Yes, remember we have more information that the roller coaster men have protected the youngster from Mapocho. And I'm thinking, having sort of a mind that Mapocho might be coming and kill the cops. But when we checked the information and checked the way that they were moving on the ground, not seeing them, they tell us the sticks by themselves, they are safe from Mapocho.
Yeah.
The cops are safe. Because they were not, the cops were not running. You can see on the road, they were going up and down with the females all together. That the cops were not really in impression from Mapocho. They were just like moving because they can move far more west because they don't want to join with them. It could be something else that really they fear. Maybe it's because of hunting. When they hunt something, the males will take over from the females, the meat. So it's one of the things that
just a nervousness. But yeah,
I think they don't want to join them because they need to raise the youngster. Once they kill something small, they can able to share with the youngster.
Yeah.
And I've seen the behavior of Stick Sprite. We have seen them, one youngster kill the steenbok.
Yeah, that was awesome.
And the rest of the female and the youngster, they don't interfere. They stay behind. But once, if it's a male involved, on that kind of a behavior, a male would like to take off from the youngster. The female doesn't like that. I think that is my fear from